Hello everyone, I am Cyrus and welcome back to my channel SciTech. In today's video, I'll try to do the PUBG graphics or gameplay comparison between the MI11 versus the POCO F3 and the Redmi K40 device. So let's see friends, which phone has a better graphics comparison and which phone has a better output as well, and which will be supporting 90fps and all those things we'll try to see in this complete entire video. So make sure to watch till end of the video to get to know all the amazing results about the both the phones. And just in case if you're watching first time this channel, make sure to subscribe to my channel fan SciTech Guru for more interesting information. And the Redmi K40 and the POCO F3, they both use the Snapdragon 870 chipset, and the MI11 uses the Snapdragon 888 processor. So this is a kind of very high-end processor from the Snapdragon right now at the moment, and which is really very amazing friends using this phone. And let me try to show you quickly what type of refresh rate I'm trying to use. So I'm trying to use at the 120Hz and with Quad HD resolution. That's a high resolution which I am trying to use, which by default it's the highest. So as you can see friends, 120Hz display refresh rate. So both are enabled with the 120Hz refresh rate, and let's see which phone will perform how. Now let me try to open the PUBG game at same time, and let's see friends which phone will open the faster. So both phones I clicked at same time, as you can see here, and let's see which phone will open the faster. And is the temperature reading on the MI11 38 degrees? So both are at 38 degrees. And I think the POCO F3, both phones, they did open at same time, so there's not much lag I did see. So both phones open at same time, and let me try to clear all these things. And if you're interested in this kind of live wallpapers and more details on the POCO F3, so make sure to check this playlist of the POCO F3. You can find so many amazing videos on the POCO F3 friends. And let me try to disable all of these things, and let me try to go to the quickly the settings. So first thing, every time whenever I compare the PUBG, I'll try to always show you the real time, like default graphics, what you can get. So without using any kind of GFX tool, no tricks, nothing, by default what you are getting out of the box. So let's go to the settings, and as you can see friends, so both phones, they don't support 90fps by default. I'm waiting for the update from the PUBG to come, so maybe in the future we might be able to see the update, but right now at the moment there is no 90fps. So unfortunately that's another drawback here. And let me try to show you. So both phones are capable at smooth and extremes, balanced and extremes, HDR and extremes, as you can see. So right now it's downloading the Ultra HD. So I think even this Ultra HD and the Ultra is possible. Same thing, it's gonna happen even I think in this phone as well. As you can see, Ultra HD and Ultra. So both are having same. The Snapdragon 870 and the Snapdragon 888, both are exactly kind of same default settings you are getting. So there is nothing much difference overall. So right now it's the time to test the high end settings. So let me try to use the Ultra and HD, Ultra HD and the Ultra settings. So I'm trying to use the maximum settings, everything, as you can see friends. So let's see how which phone will perform better. So I know a lot of users, they do use the with the smooth and extreme or HDR and extreme, but I just want to see the performance level of this both Snapdragon processors. So both are on and both are starting at same time, and let's see the real time tracking of this tool using the Game Turbo tool. So which phone will give the better results? So make sure to subscribe and do like this video friends, because it takes a lot of time and effort in making this many videos possible, a lot of comparisons. So since a lot of users are interested only in the HDR and extreme settings, so let me try to use only the HDR and extreme settings. So HDR and extremes are selected in both the phones. So as you can see here, so one thing is that in the POCO F3, whenever the temperature increases to the maximum, the screen brightness will automatically will decrease. So let me try to show you the temperature right now. It's 42 degrees on the MI11, and let me try to so the real-time FPS, how much I'm getting. So real-time FPS, I'm getting consistently about 60 FPS in this phone, and 60 FPS even on the MI11 as well. So no issues with the real-time FPS meter, as you can see, your friends, clearly. And the CPU and the GPU utilization, you can see the CPU it utilizing only 20% on this Poco F3 and the Redmi K40, which is called. And in the Mi 11, it utilizing up to 30%. That is the one thing which I noticed. So let me try to slightly zoom in inside so you can exactly focus on the FPS meter, how much the both phones are generating real-time FPS. So both are very consistent in terms of the temperature, in terms of the FPS meter, 60 FPS. So no issues in terms of the 60 FPS. So make sure to comment below, friends, what are the other phones you want me to compare this kind of PUBG gameplay. Definitely I'll do my best to compare this PUBG game. So now I'll try to jump at same time in both phones and show you the results, how it's coming in the both the phones. So this with the HDR and extreme settings I'm trying to use. The Snapdragon 888, obviously it will be very good in terms of the playing games, and Snapdragon 870 is also really amazing, 61 FPS. And for more interesting videos, make sure to subscribe and follow me regularly, friends. And I think this will give you the clear idea about how is the Snapdragon 870 processor is actually. It is quite powerful enough to play this kind of games without any problem. So make sure to comment below, friends, what are the other games you want me to compare and do comparisons. Definitely I'll do my best to compare all other games as well in the future. So let me try to run and show you the results, what I was able to get it. So 60 FPS and 61 FPS. So that's it, friends. This is a quick PUBG graphics comparisons. And by demonstrating you the default settings what you'll be getting. And for more future videos, make sure to subscribe and follow me regularly, because every day I'll be posting new updating things of the Poco F3 device. So thank you, friends, for watching this video, and see you in the next video, friends. Until then, bye.